Hello everyone, welcome back my YouTube channel Salesperson. So today I'm going to show you how to work on the workbench using Salesforce, how to deploy packages using workbench in Salesforce. Okay, so if you are new in this channel, so please subscribe my YouTube channel Salesperson and please watch this video until end because it's very important for us if you are working in deployment part. So let's get started without any further delay. Okay, so here you can see this is the introduction to Workbench, and you know Workbench is a tool provided by the Salesforce, and Salesforce which can be used to perform below options, or we can say that actions, right? So there are so many actions in Workbench. We can do all the operations like execute REST API, execute SOAP API, execute SOQL queries, retrieve and deploy the code, data import and export, and many more. Okay, so this is the all purpose to use the workbench into the our daily routine. Okay, so if you are a Salesforce developer or admin or anything as you have, so you can work with the help of workbench. So this is the another tool to deploy your metadata in one or to another or retrieve the data one or to another or. Okay, so let's get started with some practical demo. So I have two org. Now you can see I have two org, like source org and target org. Okay, and under the source org, let me create one object that is called custom object. So let me create one custom object here, like custom object, and this custom object having the name like anything as you want, but for demo purpose, so right now I am entering like demo obj, something like that, or demo, just demo like that. Okay, so demos like that, and just save it, and here you can see our custom object is created now. Okay, so this custom object having by default some fields, okay, provided by the Salesforce, like standard fields. Here you can see like created by, demo name, last modified by, and owner. Okay, so this is our custom object. So my intention is I want to deploy this object with the help of workbench or package into the target org. Okay, so under the target org you cannot see in this object here like demo. So let me search in demo, and here you cannot see any demo name here like object manager, under the object manager, right? So how to deploy this object, custom object, into the target org with the help of workbench. Okay, so first of all, under the source org we have to create some package, like under the quick find you have to search like package, and under the package manager, so you have to create your package name. So here you can see, so if you don't know about the package, unmanaged package or managed package or anything as you want, so you can watch my previous video regarding this package options. So let me create new package, okay, like demo custom object, like that. Okay, just save it, and here you can see my package is created now. Now it's time to add our component under this package. So how to add? With the help of this add button we can add. Okay, and just change this component type as custom object, like custom object. So just search this custom object, and here you can see my custom object demo. Just select all the checkbox here regarding this demo object and add to package here. Okay, once you select this object, and now the object regarding dependencies listed out here, like this is object, this is the page layout, all the things. Okay, so this is our package name, here you can see demo custom object, right? So it's time to retrieve this package from the workbench. How to retrieve that? So here you can see this is my workbench, and let me log in first workbench. Now here you can see this is a workbench. Now I agree to the term and condition and log in with the Salesforce, and here you can see after some time I just logged in my source org, and now under the this is the workbench UI, or user interface, we can say that, like we can say that, like setting, logout, help, about, info, queries, data, migration, utility. Under the migration, you can see two options like deploy and retrieve, right? So just click this retrieve first. And if you have some like package.xml file, so you can retrieve with the help of this file and choose file from here. Otherwise, you can use your package name here. So our package name is like demo custom object, like, okay. So just copy this package dot like demo custom object and paste it here. And now it's a single package. Just check this button and click next. And here you can see successfully stage retrieve request, and click this retrieve. Now one process is going on, and here you can see like succeeded. Okay, and here you can see one button is download zip file, right? So just let me go and click this download zip file, and you can see my package is downloaded here. Okay, you can see here. Okay, so I want to deploy this package metadata file into the target org with the help of Workbench. So how to do that? This is the one part, like retriever part. Now it's time to deploy the part. So first of all, let me log out here. Okay, and now it's time to deploy this metadata into the target org, right? So let me agree here term and condition and just log in. And here you can see there are so many options. Okay, here you can see. Okay, so let me choose this target org. Under the target org, you can see my username from here, like under the setting. Okay, so setting, just go to the setting, and here you can see LWC study. Just copy this username. Okay, and just log in with different here, different username, and click this one. And now I'm successfully logged in here. You can see here. Okay, so I successfully logged in into the target org with the Workbench. Now it's time to deploy that package into the target org. So how to do that? Under the migration tab, you can see like one option, deploy. Just click this deploy, and here you can see different types of options, like choose a zip file to deploy any applicable options, like choose file. Choose file means this one, we already download this package. And here there are so many options like auto package update, ignore warning. Just click this ignore warning and roll back on the error, and single package. And if you have some test cases, so you can check your test cases like run local test, otherwise leave it as it is. Just click the next. And after that, you can see successfully staged. Now it's time to deploy this one. So just click this deploy button, and now you can see one process is going on. The status is pending now, and after some time, you can see the status like succeeded. Okay, and under the result, you can see the success component. Just click this success, and this is the demo layout. Okay. And once you click this demo, you can see this is the custom object. And once you go this target org, like let me go first this object manager, and let me refresh this one, and you can see the output under this target org as a demo object under object manager. So let me search like as a demo here, and you can see my object like demo, right? So you can see this demo object here. This is the custom object. And also one thing is there, like once you click this setup, and you can check the deployment status, like deploy. Once you search this deploy and just click this deploy status, now you can see the deployment status. Just click this, and here you can see 11:35 a.m. time, and just click this view details, and you can see the component, like two components here, like deployment component. So this is the way to deploy your metadata or package with the help of Workbench into the target org. Okay, so I hope you learned something new from here, and please subscribe my YouTube channel for more updates like this. And till then, bye bye, take care.